So I'll double click on my drums to create my drums. And then I'll double click up here to create the loop. I'll put a kick on beat one, snare, and clap on beats two and four. Turn that button on to preview the sounds. And then I'll really quickly duplicate out a hi-hat on 16th notes. Actually, I'll move that down by clicking on the key of the drum and using the down arrow to move. I'll click up at the top on the 120 and bring that down to 75. Make it a little bit slower. Now I'll go into instruments and instrument rack, and I'll find some synth keys. And I'll click and drag that to my second track. Double click on the empty clip slot, and this time I'll do a 4-bar loop. So I'll click on length where it says 1, type in 4, and hit enter. Now I'll draw in 1A. Then I'll hold Alt or Option on my keyboard and click and drag up so I can create a bunch of other notes at the same length. Then I'll select all of those notes and hit Command D, and I'll use the up arrow to transpose it to a different chord. Then I'll repeat the process a couple more times to create a 4-chord progression over 4 bars. Let's hear how that sounds. Another good key command to know is shift down or up arrow. On selected notes, we'll shift them down or up an octave. So I've just created an inverted chord just by taking the two top notes and bringing them down. Now add a bass. And I'll click and drag that over to drop files and devices here. I don't have a third MIDI track here, so dropping them on the audio tracks won't do anything. But I'll drop it over here. It'll create a new MIDI track for me, as well as create the instrument that I just selected. Double click on the empty clip slot. And now I have a 1-bar loop that I can start programming notes into. And I'll use shift down arrow to bring that down an octave. All right, so for the last step, what I want to do is arrange out my clips to the arrange window. Tab toggles between the arrange window and the session window. Session window, you can kind of think of as your piece of scratch paper. They're short loop ideas. The arrange window is kind of where you're going to build up your arrangement with Lego blocks. Now what I'll do is I will go down over here to the right side, the stop button, and that'll stop all of my clips from playing right when I start the whole arrangement. Now I'll go up to the top and arm the arrangement to record, and I'll trigger off the first clip that I want to play for my song. So it's recording in real time, and I want to trigger off the next sound when I want it to come in with this little play button on the loop. Stop a clip. You can hit the stop button at the bottom of each track. I'll stop the playback, and now you can see all of my clips here were recorded to the arrangement window when I hit tab and flip over. The most confusing thing here that you're gonna have to know about is this button. Since you can have a mix of tracks playing from the arrangement and from the session view, you actually have to click this button to arm the arrangement. Right now it's kind of grayed out and see-through, and it's not actually gonna play the arrangement, what we have there. So I have to hit this button up here at the top, the back to arrangement button, and that will actually arm our arrangement now. And if I play from here, it'll actually play only the drums, and then the bass will come in over there. So let's hear it. And then if I fast forward over to here, our bass will drop in. And from there, I can further move around my clip. So if I wanted it to actually start at one, I can get the little hand icon and move that over. I can have this start on right on beat, right on bar 5. I can have my chord start right on bar 9. And I can further go in and do some edits. For instance, I could click right here and hit Command E, or go to Edit, Split. And now I have two unique copies of the drum loop that I created in the session view. What that means is if I go over here and I click on the hi-hat key and hit delete to delete all of my hi-hats, you can see that it has updated this first unique copy with no hi-hats. My second unique copy still has the hi-hats. So let's listen to that. And actually, I think I want the bass line to drop in right at the beginning and the chords to kind of drop in a little bit earlier as well.